3, 2, 1.
The fact that you're literally going to look at the things that people do and your whole viral thing is going to be you ranting on how stupid it is and that you just want to get in front of more people so that you can spread more value for free and that's all you're trying to do. But you have to sit in these meetings where you're looking at what's viral and you're like, is people really doing this dumb shit?
I took this company to where it's at, and I used the word I on purpose. Mm. I took this company to where it's at by making sure that it didn't bleed long if it was bleeding. Mm. Right? If it bleeds for a purpose. And so, what do you think needs to happen so that we're bleeding for a purpose and everything that we do, there's a reason? So what do you think needs to happen?
It's just like growth strategies. It's got to be collaboration and
I remember watching Gary Vee's first like 6 months of videos. That shit's on his phone. Yeah. Just kind of shaking around, and I mean, nothing was professional. Mm-hmm. But I mean, he had 500,000 people following him in the first 6 months of what I saw.
Yeah.
I mean, it's insane. So I don't know. People want authentic.
Like every expense it takes away from ad spend, and for me, I'm still gonna do the ad spend. But the whole goal of this thing is to be able to bring on other people, and
we'll need to bring them on quicker rather than later.
Like, yeah,
we'll need to be able to bring.
And we can bring them on just because of the quality. Like, people will come on board just because of the quality of what we're putting out. Like, I believe that 100%. But they're not going to stay long if their pages stop growing. You know, like,
yeah, yeah.
If
they're not seeing results, man, people won't pay. Like, we got
to... And it's just, it's unfortunate that it's just the way social media works. Like, people base it off numbers. So I think there needs to be a new focus on just like growth hacking.
You know, Gary Vee and a lot of people would tell you to reach out to your closest friends and family, the ones that'll tell you hopefully the truth, and ask them questions about different things like your strong points, your weak areas. I still believe though with doing that, like that's important and it's certainly a necessary step, but I think there's still, people really aren't gonna tell you the truth. Like even if they do love you, they're still going to be biased. They're still going to tell you a little bit of what you want to hear, or at least guard you from the real truth. But I think there's so many good profiling assessment tools out there.
All right, guys. So something that's been on my mind for quite a while and just kind of wanted to get it off my chest. And we discussed a little bit of it in this morning's meeting with our No Hook Media team. And it's just this general concept of creating content on social media for the purpose of it going viral, or for the purpose of it getting a lot of comments, or the purpose of it getting shared, and having that be the focus rather than the message be the focus, the vision that we're trying to put out there, the movement that we're trying to create. Honestly, it gets frustrating at times. There's sometimes where I feel like we're doing everything right, but sometimes it feels like nothing. And sometimes, quite frankly, it just feels like everything is so just like... And a lot of that is based on these analytics and algorithm changes. This person says post 5 times. This person says post 1 time. This person says use hashtags. So it's just so much information. It's important for you to know that our sole thought process is, how can we provide people with the most value? How can we make the biggest impact? And what that doesn't look like necessarily is your, you know, social media 101, how to get a video to go viral. Because those things are very They're gimmicky. They're very based on just impulses. What we try to do is provide content that you're actually going to learn something, that you're actually going to take value from, that you're actually going to be able to take, implement in your daily life, and have it make a difference. And so I think with that, there's a number of things that I wanted to address. The first of which is something that we're gonna start doing here very soon, and that is creating a focus group. We wanna create a group of about 10 to 12 people from all walks of life, but just get a good mashup of all these different people, and then would be able to get on a Zoom like webinar conference with us, and us ask questions. Stuff like, hey, what are you seeing in your newsfeed? What are you not seeing in your newsfeed? Like, if you were to consume the vlog, the daily vlog, are you consuming it on Facebook or are you consuming it on YouTube? Or are you now listening to it on iTunes now that we have the audio version? Different things like that so that we can get feedback. Another big thing is to be able to for us to be able to do some A-B testing. So us to be able to create, you know, a 5-minute version of a vlog and then a 25-minute version of the same day's material and show both of them and just ask questions like, hey, which one captured your attention quickest? We can read statistic after statistic, study after study, but things are changing so rapidly. We really want to be able to bring that information in and collect that data ourselves. And we would love your help in doing that. What we will provide in return, I don't know. But what I can tell you is there's nothing that we've ever done that we don't go above and beyond in the ROI for a person that's willing to invest in us and spend time helping us. So whether that means that we spend time on a FaceTime with you, helping you with your business, or whether that means that we send you some books, you know, whatever. We'll figure something out. But if that's something that you're interested in, please, please, please send me a Facebook message, send me a DM on Instagram, or just send me an email to info@tylerharrispage.com. info@tylerharrispage.com and just say, I'm interested in the focus group. That's pretty much the consensus. There was a lot more frustration this morning, but I think I've gotten over that a little bit now. But it's just this dynamic between wanting to have good analytics, wanting to have, you know, the engagement, the likes, the shares, the comments, but also not caring about that stuff at all, quite frankly. Like, when we put out the hour-long vlog, the speech that I did out in California, and I woke up the next morning and it had 8 likes or 6 likes or something like that, I look at that and I'm just like, awesome. Because I know the value of that episode was incredible. And I know that if someone did watch it, that they got a ton out of it. And I got a lot of messages from people that did. But just to say that I'm gonna do a 3-minute video that cuts 95% of the value out, but just puts it in a bite-sized chunk that more people can see for 3 seconds or 10 seconds, whatever a view's counted as. But at the end of the day, all we want to do here, No Hook Media, and with my content, Joseph's content, all of our content is impact lives, provide value, and make a difference. And that's what we're gonna continue to strive for, regardless of what the algorithm may say, regardless of what the analytics may say. All we care about is what you say.